Good day from Chem Help ASAP. Let's cover a beloved topic, Michaelis-Menten enzyme kinetics. Enzymes are proteins, large molecules made of amino acids. What they do is convert one molecule, a substrate, to another molecule, a product. Enzymes are molecular machines that accelerate reaction rates. They are catalysts. A mock reaction is shown at the bottom of the slide. Enzymes make great drug targets. If you can block the action of an enzyme, then you can potentially change the biochemistry and maybe a disease in an organism. Before we think about blocking an enzyme, we need to understand the math behind them. We have three things on this screen. At the top is our reaction, which has been expanded to show more detail, yet still simplified. Below is a graph of how the rate of the reaction, V, the y-axis, changes with the concentration of the substrate, S, the x-axis. An equation is on the right. Like all chemical reactions, enzyme-catalyzed reactions are controlled by collisions. As you increase the concentration of a reagent, like the substrate, you get more collisions and the rate of the reaction increases. Notice that the rate does not increase linearly. The rate tapers off at some point. It plateaus. This taper begins as the concentration of the substrate overwhelms the ability of the enzyme to perform the reaction, to catalyze the reaction. The enzyme is said to be saturated. Most enzymes follow this graph, and scientists have found that the curve can be modeled with the equation on the right. This is called the Michaelis-Menten equation. We do have two new terms. Vmax is the maximum y value for the equation, the top of the plateau, which we have not really reached in this graph. The other term is the Michaelis constant, Km, and we'll need to spend some time discussing that constant. The Michaelis constant, Km, is actually a mix of several terms. All the rate constants in our simplified reaction. In an enzymatic reaction, the substrate binds the enzyme reversibly. It binds and releases, and our two rate constants indicate these forward and reverse processes. Sometimes the enzyme-substrate complex reacts to form a product, which is immediately released. That gives another rate constant for the reaction, K2. Those three rate constants together determine Km, as shown in the equation in the bottom right. Sometimes people say that Km is the affinity of an enzyme for a substrate. That's not really true. The affinity is described by this first equilibrium. Once we add K2 into Km, Km is no longer the affinity. It's similar, but it's not identical to the affinity. It is generally true that substrates with a small Km do have a higher affinity. Of course, Km values are specific for an enzyme-substrate pair. Just because a substrate has a small Km for one enzyme does not mean it has a small Km for other enzymes. That's our quick introduction to the Michaelis-Menten equation. Although a simple equation, it does accurately model the activity of many enzymes. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe, like, or leave a comment or question. Take care.